Hi, I'm Glenroy Wason. I go to the International Arts of Business School, and we are en route to North Atlantic Industry, and we are going to meet Bill Forman.
So we are at North Atlantic Industries, the makers of vibration condensing, motor controlling, yaw pitch roll negating mechanics for the Predator drone, and commercial off-the-shelf power supplies for all kinds of military avionics. We'll find out what that means in a little bit, but we're going to meet Bill Forman, who is the CEO and founder of this company, along with his partner Wayne, an engineer, and they built this up and become one of the major contractors for building electronic stuff for militaries all across the world. So we're going to take a tour of their facility and we're going to find out what makes them tick.
So at North Atlantic Industries, we're in the aerospace and defense industry. We design and manufacture high-tech instrumentation that goes on board a variety of mobile platforms. So it could be a commercial airplane like a 747 or an Airbus plane, or it could be a helicopter or a ship or a ground-based vehicle. So we sell all over the world. About 20-25% of sales are international, and it's a wide variety of customers. It's a who's who list, so we're very proud of what we do. But those customers are from Boeing and Airbus to Northrop Grumman to Lockheed to Raytheon to China Airlines, Singapore Airlines, American Airlines, a wide variety of companies. And it's really based upon the foundation of the people that we have. So basically, if you work with talented people that know how to collaboratively work together, there's nothing you can't accomplish.
You're teaching kids about entrepreneurship, letting them know that it's an option. How do you write a business plan? What separates you from actually opening a business of your own? Not everybody will, but you know, learning at least what entrepreneurship is all about will open the doors for a lot of them. That's what NFTE really fundamentally does.
I started this company in 1992. My father was an entrepreneur. He ran a roll form steel company, so I kind of had an entrepreneurial bug from him. And my parents taught me I can accomplish whatever it is I want to. So that's important, by the way. That's 80% of the game, is they just told me, whatever you want to be, Bill, you can be, and you're going to be successful. There's below your shoulders and above your shoulders. And below your shoulders, I was going to make $5.25 an hour. And if I really work at it, I'm going to end up making $10 an hour. And above the shoulders, it was kind of unbounded in terms of the earnings potential and in terms of the creativity of what I was actually going to be able to do. So I worked in the technology industry. One of them is Dell Computer, which I'm sure all of you have heard. And so I was able to work with very intelligent, very successful people. And so I learned from them on someone else's nickel. So I didn't start at this age and say, I want to be an entrepreneur. I built it to a reasonable money, not a lot of money, but a reasonable amount, enough for me to buy a very declining company. That revenues have declined every year for 5 years. So I basically got a very good deal on it. And we started as a test measurement company. So that, remember that instrument company you did that little circle around? That's where we started with 20 employees. Today we're 120 employees. And why we're 120 employees is because we've managed to attract some very talented people. We have acquired some small companies that fit with the company, and those companies fit in terms of what products our existing customers were buying already. We talked to the customers that we were selling to already. We said, what else do you buy and what else do you need? And those were the products we developed, but we went and bought another company that did that. So we compete in an industry where there's been for two decades consolidation and downsizing. So all these big companies you read about, you know, Boeing and Northrop Grumman and Lockheed, have much less people. If you ignore all the acquisitions, they've been buying all these companies, and when they buy them, they lay off 3,000 people. Well, when you lay off 3,000 people, they're looking around saying, well, how are we going to get the work done? Well, the way they're going to get the work done is they want to partner with a small entrepreneurial company, they can get things done in a fifth the time that they do.
My dream was to be an entrepreneur, but it was just some people that I picked out in my life. So as you go through life, you have to pick out mentors. So I'm really a blend of many people, from my mother, my father, to other businessmen, to people I've worked for. I selectively picked and chose who I want to be like, people at an older stage of life, unfortunately I'm getting to that point, not there yet, but getting there, want to give back. So ask them questions.
Do you feel you have reached your goal as an entrepreneur or still feel like you have more to do for your business?
That's a question about quality of life and your life's passion. So I've always been in a rush to get someone, somewhere. And so my issue has been, I've never been satisfied, to be honest. And when am I as a person truly happy, okay? And at some point in your life, you need to say, you know what, it's okay. If this is what it is, it's okay. And some people get caught up in the money thing or the power thing, and they always want more. And so what's important in life is to have a sense of satisfaction and peace within yourself.
I wanted the kids to get exposed to real entrepreneurs so they could see the passion firsthand of people that actually create and run businesses and understand the human aspect, which is even more important than, you know, the analytical aspect of your profit and loss statements and your accounting and your business plan.
What this is this room is filled with ovens. So to make sure a product's working reliably, we have to life cycle test it. So you take that product, whether it's a board or an instrument, and you put it in an oven, and you cycle temperature. So you make it hot, you make it cold, you make it hot, you make it cold. So think of something on an airplane flying at 35,000 altitude feet, it's very cold. Or think of something in Iraq, in a desert, it's very hot. That's to ramp the ovens up temperature very quickly. So doing it with an electric motor would take way too long.
And hopefully to identify with these entrepreneurs and people, realize, wow, I could be like that guy or like that girl. I could create a business if he or she has done it.
Now you know where the Predator drones, vibration reducing, gyroscopically correct, high signal motor control unit comes from. And does that enrich your feeling and understanding of the entrepreneurship universe? No truer word ever spoken. NFTE students have created a company called Muffin Milk, which is the Muffin Milk branded t-shirt. It's a successful venture, and it says Muffin Milk on it.
Oh,
and there's a picture of a muffin and milk.
Okay.
And you may wear that, and that will remind you of this time together.
Success means being happy. There's no dollar figure with it. There's no power thing with it. It's finding a passion in life and following through on it.
I learned that just because you be successful, that you should still always go back and always try to learn more, that you shouldn't just be satisfied, and if you have an opportunity to learn, just take advantage of it.